Don't slap a low cut on your kick or bass instruments just because some random tutorial told you so. Do they tell you to cut everything below 30 Hz to free up headroom? Well, check your peak meter before and after applying your low cut filter, and you will notice that the peak level got higher after you applied the low cut. You're not gaining headroom, you're losing it. But why? This is due to a phase shift at the cutoff frequency. EQs always introduce phase shifts. That's just how EQs work. A phase shift might lead to increased peak levels, and it blurs the punchiness and clarity of your sound. It doesn't happen every time though, and it's different for every sound and EQ setting. But there are two fixes to this problem. Number one, use a low shelf or a gentler slope on the low cut to reduce the impact of the phase shift. And number two, use linear phase mode. It also introduces phase shift, but preserves the phase relationship across the frequency spectrum. But it introduces its own problems though, like pre-ringing, latency, and it can also smear the transients, especially on percussive sounds. It's always a trade-off. I'm not saying you shouldn't do low cuts at all, but I want you to use your lovely ears to make an informed decision. Don't just trust what someone said on the internet. In fact, you don't even have to trust me when you trust your ears. Trust your ears. Trust your ears.